color map display is used to display a series of data in relation to a third parameter. For example, a color map might be used to display pressure versus frequency versus some sort of tracking parameter, like time or RPM. To open a new color map display, press the Create a Picture button and then select Color Map. To populate the display, drag and drop a block from the tree into the color map. Since this is pressure data, I'm going to change my format to dB. In any display, you can access a quick list of tips and tricks by right-clicking and selecting mouse and keyboard tips. Many of these are applicable for the color map as well. For example, zooming in any direction, X, Y, or Z, can be done by dragging the mouse. Let's see how this works in practice. Let's say I want to zoom in on this natural frequency. I simply click and drag, and the map adjusts. I can press backspace to zoom out. Notice that this can be done in any direction, X, Y, or Z. You can also zoom in on a diagonal by clicking and dragging. Again, press backspace to zoom out. It's also possible to apply weighting and processing to the color map. Right-click on the Y-axis, and under Processing, there are options to integrate, differentiate, or weight the map. Again, because this is an acoustic map, it may make sense to A-weight the data. You can see how the lower frequencies are affected. For now, I'll leave it without any weighting. Perhaps one of the most powerful features of the color map is the ability to apply processing cursors. Let's see how this works. I'll zoom in on this frequency range, and I'll add a second display by coming under my picture menu, pressing edit, and then adding a front-back display. Then I'll click OK. I'll apply a processing cursor by right-clicking in my map and going under add processing cursor, and then you can see the four different options, Z, cross, order, and frequency. There's more details on each one of these types of cursors in the article body. For now, we'll add an order cursor. You can see that the cursor processing window pops up with a block. I'll drag and drop the block into that front-back display that I created. Again, it might make more sense to look at this in dB. As I drag my cursor in my color map, I can see the order cut update on the right. If I want to quickly snap it to an order, I can double-click the cursor, type in a value, and hit enter. Sometimes it may be desired to rotate the axes of a color map. For example, let's say I wanted the horizontal axis to be RPM for both of my pictures. In that case, I can right-click on the map, go to Options, Miscellaneous, and change the orientation from XZ to ZX. Now both of our maps have RPM along the horizontal axis. Finally, it's possible to change the color scale on the map. Perhaps you have a certain palette that you like to use for your reports, or you simply just have a color preference. By right-clicking on the Y-axis, choosing color scale, and then changing the palette, you can adjust the way that the color map is presented.